I'm wearing double denim, which I've just noticed.
You are double denim, that
which is... a bit of a faux pas.
It's a strong look.
No, it's not strong. It's a mild look, isn't it? Because it's blue. Then I basically didn't look. We were in a dark bus. I didn't look at what I put on.
This is Sarah Champion for Absolute Radio. Day 3 of the Isle of Wight Festival. Razorlight are taking to the main stage a little bit later on. Andy Burrows joins us now. So we worked out that we met a few years ago here with We Are Scientists.
That's right, yeah.
I don't remember when that was, do you?
No, it was a lovely sunny day.
Yeah.
And that's all we need to know.
Yeah, regardless of anything else, I mean, this is my 11th Isle of Wight Festival, but time has definitely warped in the last 18 months.
Well, we Razorlight, I last played here with Razorlight in 2005, so that's a real warp of a thought.
Yes, it is. Mm. And of course, obviously, this was meant to happen last year. How far into kind of preparations or set list were you then?
Well, last year, we weren't a band. We were on a hiatus. We were on a decade-long hiatus. Well, in terms of the four members of the band.
Yes.
This time last year, we had no set list.
Because you weren't a band?
No.
And now you are?
Yeah.
And how does it feel?
The set list is strong.
Good.
Yeah.
Good, because we've had a long wait for live music.
Yeah, absolutely. It feels amazing. And for us, even though we didn't have a set list this time last year, the set list feels very familiar and feels very exciting. It's lovely to be here at the Isle of Wight.
And you've had a couple of festivals to warm up for this one.
Lake Fest,
Gone Wild.
We played a few shows this summer, Not loads and loads, but enough to sort of limber up.
Walking out into the crowd for the first time on Friday, the atmosphere was electric. It's always good at this festival. It's a legendary festival.
Well, and I imagine everybody's just so happy to be back with each other.
It's a release. I think it's a pent-up kind of, people want to dance and shout and sing.
Yeah.
It was a kind of palpable feeling out there, and it's just really exciting. When you took to the stage for the first time, how was that for you? Did you feel that energy? Did it feel
different? I think the same for every band and artist that's played this summer. When you turn up at a show, the fascination with seeing a lot of people is probably more fascinating than it is for any member of the crowd looking at the band. It's like the tables have completely turned. You know, it used to be very exciting to turn up and see, my God, is such and such going to walk on stage? Now the bands are walking on going, are they going to be there? You know, the crowds are the star, and we've missed them, and I think we're just all feeling very, very grateful for the fact that this is slowly coming back. People, I guess, still feel a bit funny about it, but for the most part, it feels like everyone's just overjoyed to be back watching music and being together and seeing each other.
It is. It's just sheer joy. I felt,
Have nothing. You enjoyed being at the festival this time?
I genuinely, certainly on Friday, and it's my first kind of live music event in 18 months. So I felt like people were more maybe living in the moment than, there was a lot less sort of filming and that going, and it was just, let's enjoy this.
Absolutely.
Because for a lot of people in the crowd, obviously it's been 18 months since live music. For some people, it's their first ever festival. I was watching a dad and his daughter front row of the crowd yesterday thinking, what a lovely moment that must be. What's your kind of memory of your first live, either festival or gig? And did you have that kind of definitive moment where you looked on stage and thought, that's what I'm going to do with my life?
Yes, I think I must have done, because I definitely felt like from a very early point in my life, I decided I wanted to be a drummer in a band. So I must have done. I can't remember what gig that was. First festival I went to would have been something in 95 or 6, and it's dreadful. I mean, like, the bands were wicked, but it's awful. Like, the tent vibe and the sinking into the mud. I think I was just like, the quicker I can get into the VIP bit and hurry up and be in a famous band, the better. Cause it clearly,
that was the inspiration.
Yeah, that was the inspiration. Like, all you need is a tour bus and an escape, and it'll be great. I don't know. I can't really remember, but certainly from as young as I can remember, I was like, I want to be a drummer. Like, 9, 8, 9.
Yeah.
I feel quite lucky that, because it's hard to know what you want to do in life.
It is.
I feel very lucky that I was just like, well, I just want to play the drums, so.
And that's the life for me.
That's the life for me.
So do you remember what the first gig you went to was?
It was a band called Meccano Pig in somewhere in Winchester. And the guy, the lead singer, went on to be Aqualung.
Oh, wow.
That was the first time I was allowed out on my own, like 11 years old, to watch a band. So I watched a band called Meccano Pig, and it was the guy out of Aqualung. I met him at a gig in Chicago. that we were playing with Razorlight. Some, I can't remember what the why he was there or what I was doing. But I remember I went up to him, I told him that story, and it really freaked him out. And he didn't talk to me, and I gave him his number, and he didn't respond. I think he was really freaked out. Anyway, that's...
Yeah, I've had a few of those moments where you're like, I really wish I hadn't. I really wish I'd kept that in my head.
Yeah, yeah. Now we're good mates, but it took about 12 years to convince him I wasn't totally weird.
And the restraining order has been lifted now. Yeah.
I was just telling him it was my first gig. It was a fairly innocent... Anyway, so I veered off.
No. Are you sticking around to enjoy the fun of the festival? We're
playing the big top. Yes. And we're playing... I think we are pretty much closing this... monumental event. Sticking around, I have to.
It's kind of in the contract.
Yeah, and then my after show is the ferry.
So before then, will you get to enjoy?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, festival? Definitely. I'm excited. Man. I'm really excited to see Supergrass. I'm very lucky because I got to make good friends over the last years with my hero Danny Goffey.
Yeah.
And I can't wait to go and watch him bash the drums with Supergrass.
I mean, Supergrass in the sunshine on the main stage. I don't think life gets much better, does it?
I mean, everyone's going to lose their mind. It's going to be brilliant. Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah. Well, I'll let you enjoy that. Thanks for talking to us
Thank you for having me.